Good Morning Bay Street is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's newsletter.
Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, February 2nd, 2011. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are fairly flat, gold's down a couple of dollars, so not a lot of guidance in the pre-market on Wednesday. Now, we're starting off looking at the VIX. The VIX, there's a divergence between the VIX and the major indexes. We've seen that several times over the past little while. The VIX came down sharply yesterday. That's supportive of higher stock prices. I really like to see the VIX back on a sell signal below 1690, but it is going in the right direction. Now, not a lot of major changes yesterday. There's not a lot to do this morning. For the TSX, we moved higher. We need to close below 13,351 on Wednesday to give us a sell signal. We're up pretty close to our target of 13,750. I don't think the market's going to stop on a dime around here, but certainly this is a major area of long-term resistance, and I think we are going to run out of steam somewhere around here. It just might not be on Wednesday. Take a look at energy stocks. They moved higher yesterday. We need to close below 324.89 to give us a sell signal. We're up at major resistance at 343.75. We'll have to see if we can break through that. Now, financial services had a huge update yesterday. They're now back on a buy signal. We're up at the top of the range, back up testing previous highs. A close below 184.37 would change things on Wednesday. We will take a look at a couple of financial services stocks later in the presentation. Now, we are up at the 187.50 level, and that stopped us a few weeks ago. That's a major area of resistance, not only on the daily charts, but the weekly charts. And it held us at the early 2010, where we were trading between 187.50, 190, finding resistance there. And then back in 2008, that's where we topped out at the 187.50 level. So that's a major area of resistance. It'd be nice if we could break through that. If we start trading above 190, then we know we're on our way to 200. But right now we're stuck at 187.50. Looking at gold stocks, they were up yesterday. We need to close above 380.97 to give us a buy signal for the index. Some stocks have generated buy signals, but not all, including my stock that I'm following, which is Eldorado. Take a look at materials. Big up day yesterday. Big up day for copper. We need to close below 416.36 to change things on Wednesday. For the Venture Exchange, 22.40.28. We're back on a buy signal for copper stocks. We're now back on a buy signal for the fertilizer index led by potash. We're on a buy signal for silver stocks as of Tuesday's close. Uranium stocks moved sharply higher yesterday. They've through this last down move in the market, they didn't generate a sell signal. Canadian dollars right on the edge of a new buy signal. Any higher close on Wednesday would do that. And it is, last time I looked, it was trading higher in the pre-market. U.S. dollar broke down. It looked like it was making a base over the last couple of days, but finally broke down yesterday. A close above 78.76 would change things for the U.S. dollar index. Crude oil turned down, having trouble up at previous highs here. We need to close below 88.45 to change things on Wednesday. For natural gas, we're looking for a close above 454. For copper, copper's moved up sharply over the last couple of days. We need to close below 431. Now, yesterday was an inside day for the price of gold, so a day of indecision. The first sign of short-term market direction is going to be a breakout of Monday's high or a breakdown of Monday's low. That should be the first sign that we know which way gold wants to go next. We do need a daily close above 1351.87. I'm bullish on the prospects of gold right now. Last week's low was probably a significant low. It was turned out to be a bullish reversal signal day, and so that usually marks the a market bottom. And it also looks like the pros are coming back to take control, but have not done so yet. So we need to close above 1351.87. If we don't get that on Wednesday, of course, that breakout point is going to continue to move lower. Now, an important lesson from last week was the crisis that we had in Egypt. It affected currencies and commodities around the world, but the price of gold really didn't move that much. And so if you hear people telling you that gold's the place to go at in a time of crisis, they really don't know what they're talking about. Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. It's certainly not a given that that's what's going to happen. So just an important lesson to take away from last week. Gold is not necessarily the place that people run to during a time of global crisis. Taking a look at the price of silver, we're on a buy signal. A close below 2738 would change that. A couple of stocks we're watching. Potash, this one's moved higher even though I thought it was not going to. We need to close below 167.07 to give us a sell signal on Wednesday, certainly leading the fertilizer sector higher. Some financial services stocks doing well right now. Believe it or not, Sun Life is putting in a new high for this move. We need to close below 31.03. The TSX is doing very well right now. We need to close below 38.01. And some of the bank stocks that have recently generated sell signals have come back, including CIBC and the Royal Bank. Last up this morning, just a quick look at the 60-minute charts. Coming off the pressure zones at the bottom of the screen, we have had a really nice move, worked our way through some early warning signals. Another one fired off at the end of the day on Tuesday. First sign of weakness is going to be an hourly close below 13,260. There's an open gap there that could potentially act as support. The next major hurdle to go over on the downside, of course, you see that we've got an uptrend line there, but 13,450. Any pullback down to 13,450, we believe the bulls are in control. If we break down below 13,450, we assume the bears are in control. Now, we're still watching gold stocks, and they're still having trouble at the flypaper channel. A breakout above the flypaper channel gives us daily buy signals for not only the index, but some of the major stocks as well. Yesterday, I introduced leveraged ETF trends, and we focused on the U.S. market. Today, I'm going to do a presentation later this morning focused on the Canadian market, and we're going to do a soft start for the Canadian ETFs. We did a hard start for the U.S. market, and we just jumped in, taking all the current positions at one time. For the Canadian market, we're going to do a soft start. We're going to buy the ETFs as the signals come up. So you'll see that later today. We'll probably post it around 11 o'clock this morning. Okay, thank you very much for your time, folks. Have a great day. We'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.